Hi to everyone. I hope all of you are doing great. So guys, today we will be playing with which I believe is the best team in the world in Foot 21. Like, honestly, you cannot get much better than this team. Like, for me personally, you have got R9 and Cruyff up top, CR7 and Mbappe down on the wings, Hullet and Vieira in the midfield, you know, Van Dijk and Maldini at the center back position. So yeah, today we will be playing with this team a full match, and I will talk you guys through it and tell you how I feel while playing this team, and is it really worth it having such a team? Like, should we, like, if you have the chance to play with this team and if you can afford this, will you go out of the way and try to afford it or no? I'll answer this question in today's video, so let's go.
Well, you got to save us some moments.
So we are currently losing this game, right? But let's see how our mega team responds to it. It's the best team in the world, man. I don't think I have personally seen a better team than this. Dominating us on the possession, man. He scored two headers, man. Two headers. That's composure right there, man. This is a very good player. He's a very good player with a great team. But that's what I'm saying, man. If he scored two headers on us, but if you are a good player and if you play at the level of your opponent, like, you can beat these teams, man. You can beat these teams. You might argue that this guy has a very good team as well. That's true, but trust me, you don't need such teams. That's what my point is for today's video. We don't just a luxury, man. This team is just a luxury. Like, it's not necessary to have this team in order to get at the level where you want to be at, right?
Oh, maybe the equalizer. Oh,
God!
The equalizer.
That bullet by Hullet, though. And now we are back into the game just like that, man. But it's a joy to play with such teams, man. It's a big joy to play with such teams. Yeah, that's how the game ends. That's very unfortunate for the opponent. But if I had finished it over there, R9 would have scored it, right? But yeah, you can say a bit of 90 minutes luck involved, but that's what I wanted to say, man. Our opponent, he played a great game. He was a very good opponent. But at the end, we got the win. Did our team help us? Maybe yes, maybe not, man. But look at that. He had like 55% possession on us. He was playing very good. But both of the goals he scored were from the crosses, you know. Maldini isn't very good in the air. Didn't expect Joe Gomez to score this. Should have brought on my keeper, that's my fault. But then we got the comeback, man. This was a very good goal. Scooped and in, dragged back, and we scored it, yeah. And then this was from a set piece. So is it joyful playing with such teams? Obviously, it feels great. But do these teams make you 100%, 200% better? No. So don't die in this dilemma of that, oh my god, if I add this team, I'll be hitting 30 and oh no, bro. If you have the skill to hit 30 and oh, you will, man. If you have the mental capacity to hit 30 and oh, you will, even with a 2 million team, 1 million team, 500,000 team. 5 million team. And yeah, that's the whole point of today's video, man. It feels great playing with such players. It's a lot of fun. But do you really need them? The answer to today's question is no.